expression that contains another fraction in its numerator and or its denominator. So examples of this could be 1/2/2/3, x plus 1/y, all over y plus 1/x, even a plus 1/a² - 9, all over 2/a + 3. Now when we reference this, this value that's on the quote-unquote numerator, we're going to call it the top, because the top has indeed a numerator and a denominator, as well as the bottom has a numerator and a denominator. So it would get kind of confusing if we just called, oh, that's the numerator, that's the denominator. So we're going to say the top and reference the top numerator, top denominator, bottom numerator, bottom denominator. There's two methods by which we can solve the problem or simplify the problem. So first method, we're going to multiply the top and the bottom by the LCD. And remember, the LCD is the LCD of the denominators, meaning the top denominator and the bottom denominator. So the LCD of 2 and 3 is going to be 6, so I'm going to multiply the top by 6 and the bottom by 6. That gives me 6/2, which equals 3, and 12/3, which will equal 4. So my final simplification is 3/4. Second method of solving is just to treat it like a division problem. And if I do treat it like a division problem, that's a fraction divided by a fraction. So 1/2 / 2/3. Well, if that's the case, then I can change it to a multiplication problem by multiplying by the reciprocal of the divisor, which would be 1/2 × 3/2. Well, 1 × 3 is 3, and 2 × 2 is 4. Another example might be 2x³/y² all over 4x/y⁵. Complex fraction. So method one, we can use our LCD. So we have y² y⁵ are our denominators. Therefore, our LCD is going to be y⁵. Multiply both the top and the bottom by y⁵, giving me 2x³y⁵ all over y² and 4xy⁵/y⁵. I can reduce. So if I reduce, this gives me y³. So 2x³y³ all over 4x, leaving me with the 2 and the 4 can reduce down to x² y³ all over 2. Taking the same problem but using method 2, which is treat it as a division problem, so flip it and turn it into multiplication. I'm going to take the 2x³y² divide by 4x/y⁵, giving me 2x³/y² times y⁵/4x. I'm just going to join them. So it's 2x³y⁵ all over 4xy². And I can reduce down to x² y³ all over 2. So both methods gives us the same solution, but sometimes one method might be a little bit easier to work with than another. But we do have two methods that we can choose to use. Let's simplify the x plus 1/y all over y plus 1x. Now my LCD is going to be xy, because if you think about it, that's x/1, y/1. So it's going to be my LCD of my denominator of the top and my denominator of the bottom, leaving me with x times y. So if I multiply the top by x times y, I'm going to distribute. So x times y, xy times x is x² y. Xy times 1/y is going to be xy/y. For the bottom, xy times y is xy². Xy times 1/x is going to be xy/x. Find the common denominator. If I find the common denominator, it's going to be Sorry about that. I did simplify. So I had a y over y, which that is going to simplify. I have an x over x, that simplifies, leaving me with x squared y plus x all over xy squared plus y. Now, here's the thing. You might get kind of confused right here, but I can pull out an LCD. I can pull out a GCF and see if I can reduce my fraction by any. So the GCF, the greatest common divisor for the greatest common factor for the numerator, is x, leaving me with xy plus 1. The GCF of the denominator is y, leaving me with xy plus 1. Oh, xy plus 1 over xy plus 1 is just 1, leaving me ultimately x over xy. Big complicated problem to get down to just x over y. Let's take another scary looking problem and simplify. So 1 minus 4 over x squared all over 1 minus 1 over x minus 6 over x squared. Now my LCD in this, when I'm looking at the LCD of the top denominator and the bottom denominator, is going to be x squared. So I'm going to multiply the top and the bottom by x squared. So if I do that, and I distribute, the x squared times 1 is x squared. X squared times negative 4 over x squared is negative 4x squared over x squared, but I can cancel out the x squareds. I'm going to distribute the x squared to the 1, giving me x squared. X squared minus 1 times minus 1 over x gives me x squared over x. X squared times negative x over x squared gives me negative 6x squared over x squared. The x squared over x will reduce down to x, and the negative x squared over x squared will reduce down to negative 6. But I'm not done yet. I still need to factor each of the now numerator and the denominator and see if it can be simplified. The top is the difference of squares, so x squared minus 4 will be x minus 2 times x plus 2. The denominator will factor into x minus 3 and x plus 2. Lo and behold, I have an x plus 2 on the top, x plus 2 on the bottom. So my final simplification is going to be x minus 2 all over x minus 3. Now to me, this is very interesting. So we're going to simplify each of our terms in this following sequence and see how it's related to the Fibonacci sequence. And I'll talk about the Fibonacci sequence in a second. But let's see, 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1, and our next number is going to be 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1. Our next number is going to be 1 plus 1 all over 1 plus 1 all over 1 plus 1 all over 1 plus 1. So let's work these through one number of our sequence, and then we'll work on the next one, and then work on the next one. So our first one, 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1. Well, 1 plus 1 is 2, so that's really 1 plus 1 half. And then 1, we can write it as 2 over 2. So 2 over 2 plus 1 over 2 just gives us 3 over 2. So the first number in our sequence is 3 over 2. Let's take a peek at our next one. 1 over 1 over 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1. This is going to give us 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1 half. But 1 plus 1 half was our 3 halves. Now we have 1 over 3 halves, but that's just the reciprocal of 3 halves. So it's 1 plus 2 thirds. 1 plus 2 thirds is 3 thirds plus 2 thirds, which gives us 5 thirds. Right, so we have a 3 halves, 5 thirds. Let's try our next one. Alright, 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1. This 1 over 1 plus 1 this last one is going to be 1 plus 1 half, which we found out was 3 halves. But 1 plus 1 over 3 halves, we found out, was 5 thirds. So our new denominator is 5 thirds. But 1 over 5 thirds is the reciprocal of 5 thirds, which is 3 fifths. Well, 1 plus 3 fifths is 8 fifths. So here's our series so far. We have 3 over 2, 5 over 3, and 8 over 5. Now, here's our Fibonacci sequence. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21. So you take the two numbers, you add them together, you get the next number in the sequence. Take the preceding number, 1 plus 2, add those together, you get 3. 3 plus 2 will give you 5. 5 plus 3 will give you 8. Look at our series here. 3 over 2, well, that's 3 and 2. 5 and 3, that's 5 and 3. 8 and 5 is 8 and 5 in our sequence. So what do you think the next number is going to be? It should be 13 over 8 if our pattern holds. So each term is the ratio of two consecutive numbers of the Fibonacci sequence. So the next one, 13 over 8. Kind of interesting how that works out that way. So here's a problem I'd like you to do and turn in for our next class session. So simplify 1 over xy all over 1 over y minus 1 over x. So in this problem, I would encourage you to find your LCD, multiply both the top and bottom by your LCD, and then continue from there. So until next lecture, be seeing you.